Stretched along the shores of the Caspian Sea, we've taken over the streets of Baku. Plenty of testing and adjustment needed here in free practice.
Solid laps here to help us calculate a good race strategy. complete and a job. Well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers. We want you to focus on your fuel-saving technique. Lift and coast through corner entry to save as much as you can whilst keeping under the minimum lap time. Job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. Don't worry about tyres, just give it everything. In this test, we just want to make sure we can lap close to our rival's pace. We'll be right back. Program complete. Program complete.
What an incredible practice session that was. But the fun doesn't stop here, though. Join us again as the rest of the weekend unfolds. And if today's practice... And a warm welcome here ahead of qualifying for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix.
Okay, that's all the checks complete. We're ready to go. I'm afraid we've dropped to P22. Thank you. afraid we've dropped to P22, P22. That's us down into P16 now. All set, we're ready to go, so let's get the car out onto the track.
A warm welcome to you all at home for today's Azerbaijan Grand Prix, a race that in its short history has already proven no stranger to drama, and where a fourth-row start is just about as likely to give you a podium as pole position, with Lance Stroll and Sergio Perez finishing third from there in 2017 and 2018, respectively. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience, and precision. 90-degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4-mile chase flat out through Sector 3 towards the finish line. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lando Norris will lead us away from pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Fernando Alonso, Russell, Oscar Piastri, Hamilton, Sainz, Gasly, Chadwick, Perez, Stroll, Albon, Smith, Hülkenberg, Ricciardo, Bottas, Ocon, Sargeant, Joe, Tsunoda, and Dennis Hauger. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. And alongside me here today in the commentary box, Anthony Davidson. Now, sadly, things didn't work out for them last time. It was a bad race. Question is, though, can they recover today?
Yes, they can, Crofty. You've got to put it behind you. Whatever happened last time, I was always told as a driver, park it, forget about it. Obviously, feel the pain when it happens, but then you can't dwell on it and carry that through to the next race. So put it behind you and just crack on with this race coming your way now.
When you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. That move was illegal, I'm afraid, mate. Return the position, give it back. watch out for understeer in the wake of the car ahead. Try to get past as quickly as you can. Push, push. Tire condition still looking good. Behind 6.9 seconds. Rain is forecast in just over 10 minutes' time. Rain in 10 minutes. Dries definitely seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. expecting rain in about 10 to 15 minutes. Approaching the pit window, you're going to be on softs. We'll be right back. No need to worry about the tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good. Gap to your teammate behind, 16.4 seconds. Push now. Okay, expect to see some rain about 10 to 15 minutes from now. Remember, box this lap. Keep an eye on your distance and the speed limit line as you approach and make sure you don't speed. Right, Jamie's coming in for a stop. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track. expecting some rain soon. Expect the first drops in the next few minutes. No need to worry about the tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good. Pressure data is currently reading zero. Assuming they still look inflated to you, we're going to guess that it's just a bad sensor. Shouldn't be anything to worry about. We'll be right back.
And so the celebrations begin, and well-earned they are indeed. It might have looked simple at times, but as any racing driver will tell you, competing at this level at the very top is anything but simple. There's no catching them now then. We have a new World Drivers' Champion. That's a spectacular victory, and with it, the championship is secure. It's been a magnificent season, and they thoroughly deserve the cheers of the crowd here today.
You always look back at a race like this and think, if I had just made that mistake there or locked up here, there would have been contact. And every one of those overtakes is a moment where you have to absolutely nail it, perfect it. And that's exactly what they're able to do today. Great stuff indeed.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport action. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
Our margins are looking good right now. I think we've got room for some more investment. Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.